Yo, Grind Gang, what is up? And welcome to the Daily Grind. I'm so excited to be here with you on episode 28. I said it really slow under my breath because I'm not actually sure if it's 28. It's this episode right here. Yo, but really though, I'm so happy to be here. You know why I'm so happy to be here? Because I had to force myself to be here. I really had to work hard today. I had to dig deep to come and not only show up, but hopefully leave you guys with the same, you know, inspiring messages that I try and bring every day with the same intensity and same passion that I bring every day. But if I was faltering, it was because I was a little bit tired today, but we're going to keep pushing through, baby, because that's just the Grind Gang way. I love you so much, and as always, I'll see you tomorrow. Yo, hey, so I can't lie, gang. I cannot lie to y'all, man. I'm exhausted. I'm like, lost is what I am, man. I started the whole new lime juicing thing, so I've been doing this like sick, nasty little rotation of like collecting scooters and juicing those all night, and then you gotta like drop them off in the morning, and then I go to class, and then we come home and I work on my scripts and like my videos, and then I do the daily grind, and then it's just a nasty little cycle that starts all over. So, it's finally caught up with me, man. And today I want to get some sleep. And then so today I was negotiating with myself and my little bro. I was like, yo, something's got to give. I was like, I can't do the daily grind or the scooters today. Like one of those two things gotta go. And he was like, whatever you do, do the daily grind. And I was like, I feels that. Because actually the daily grind was like what I didn't want to do. I was like, man, I don't want to come all like half-ass on here for the gang, you know what I mean? But then I was like, nah, he was like, it's even more important to go because then I get to talk about persistence and consistency. And that is important, super important. Oh my God, hey, bro, those noodles were insanely hot. Like I never had anything so hot. I was like, no, man, just even mentioning it, my tongue hurts just now just thinking about it. Those things were so hot. man, we've been having a lot pop off around here, you know, a lot of opportunities. We like to say something, I stole this little saying from my friend of mine, we're blessed to be busy, you know what I mean? Like, being busy is a blessing, I think. Like, a lot of people complain about being busy, and I'm like, dude, imagine if you had nothing to do, you know what I mean? Imagine if your shit wasn't popping off at all. Nobody cared about what you were up to. Nobody wanted to hang out with you. Nobody wanted, you know, your shit to go. So being busy, you know, having a bunch of shit to do, I think is way better and cooler than not having anything to do at all. You know, no existence or whatnot. So we're blessed to be busy. But either way, we do have to manage our time smart. We have to manage our body smart. Can't run ourselves into the ground. At the same time. How important is it, you know what I mean, to stay persistent and consistent? You know, so much of just anything you want to do, like, is just about not giving up. You know what I mean? It's just about being able to just keep going, even when it gets hard, even when it gets difficult. And so, you know, that's what I was thinking about with this whole live thing and about wanting to go live, because we already set the intention every single day, right? That I was going to do it once a day. Same thing with the gratitude, man. Is the gratitude started off as one page of gratitude every day, but honestly, lately it's become more of an exercise of just discipline, you know, and of just like doing exactly what I said I was gonna do. You know, I said I was gonna do this full page every day, no matter what. And, you know, it's just like with anything else, you know, when you teach yourself in one thing, you can bleed that into your entire life, right? So when I teach myself how to like beat my comfort zone or beat my limitations in the cold shower, that bleeds over to when I want to do something else. And it's the same thing like this, like, you know, this gratitude thing, it started off with that gratitude, but now I'm setting, like, teaching myself, like, when I set an intention or when I say I'm gonna do something, I follow through. And you know how there's always that time that comes in when you're trying to follow through on something and all of a sudden negotiation starts happening in your mind, right? Like, you say, oh, I'm gonna go to the gym, but then your mind all of a sudden's like, yeah, but we're tired, man, and we really did this and that, and we worked really hard today. Maybe we'll just do it tomorrow. You know that little voice that comes on? And you sometimes listen to that little voice because you think that voice is you, and you're like, you're looking out for yourself. But what I've learned is that sometimes you just can't be trusted. And you have to make sure that you're staying in line with the things that you set for yourself ahead of time, right? Not just in the moment. So like in the moment right now, I do not feel like going live, right? I didn't feel like doing an activity. But having set that intention already ahead of time means I gotta like stay consistent with that, right? You can't just always do things based on how you feel in the moment. So this is something you train though, right? Something you train. And so I've been training myself through those gratitudes a lot lately. I'm just like, dude, I've had to get up in the middle of the night. I've had to postpone sleep for an extra hour when I was already dog tired. Did all the scooter things I just talked about. And then had to stay there at 2 o'clock in the morning. And I was like, it wasn't even really about gratitude. Like I said, I wasn't even really feeling the gratitude. I was just like, I gotta do a full page. I said I was gonna do it, full page. I mean, I'm writing. But I love that it was teaching myself about this idea of I don't quit, right? Or I do what I say I was gonna do, right? I set an intention and I stick with that intention until it's complete or until I've driven it to the point in which I wanna take it, right? And so that was the only hope that I could come on to today. It's not even to really try and be inspirational or any thing like that, but just to set an example, straight up. Just to set an example and say like, look man, sometimes you gotta do those things you said you were gonna do even when you don't want to. And I would love for you to take solace in that, honestly. You know, like take strength in that. Because one of the reasons why I'm so excited about Rodtheplanter and Films Like Rose and how I like gain a lot of confidence in what I'm doing, right? I don't really worry about is this gonna work or what happens if I fail or anything like that, right? And it's due to this very one simple principle, why I have so much confidence and belief in what I'm doing and that I know that it's going to work. And that's simply because I'm just not gonna quit. You know what I mean? Like, I just don't care. Like, even if it just takes me another 50 years, like, I'm just simply not going to quit. I'll just keep figuring this out. Whether I gotta move it to a live show and a live audience, or if I gotta, like, write a book, or if I gotta make my own TV show, or if I gotta stand on the corner with signs, you know what I'm saying? But, like, I'ma just say with this shit that I got to say, no matter what, for the rest of my life. And that, like, having made that decision and that commitment and knowing that there is no really such thing as failure for me. There's only learning for me, right? I already dedicated myself to this path, so now it's not about, like, is he gonna make it or not? No, I'm gonna make it. I'm gonna make it or I'm gonna die. So regardless, it doesn't matter. I'm gonna make it or I'm gonna die. So there's no, like, is he gonna make it, right? Like, that's cool. We've already settled that. Yes, I'm gonna make it or I'm gonna die. So now I'm never looking like, what if this doesn't work? Or what if this doesn't happen? Or what if this, you know what I mean? All those what ifs and all those fears of things not like being right or being done or getting me to where I want to be, all quelled, right? Because if I'm just not there yet, fine. Work harder. Work differently. Work smarter. Learn something, motherfucker. Open up a book. You know what I mean? But I'm always in the fight. You know what I mean? I'm always in it. I'm always trying to get better. Doesn't matter. And so there's a lot of solace that comes with that, but a lot of people have a hard time committing to that. We commit to something, but then when it gets difficult, or when it gets hard, or when we get broke, or when things don't go the way we thought they were gonna go as we started, you know, so this, I mean, you can start off on a cross-country road trip and you're like, I'm gonna get there in 1.5 days, and we're gonna stop here, here, and here, and we're not gonna stop anywhere else. And you can try and plan all the way out, but when you get out there on the open road, what's gonna happen? Somebody's gonna have to piss. So you're gonna get a flat tire. There's gonna be detours. There's gonna be blocks in the road. You're gonna have to maneuver anyways, right? So this is life. But something powerful about setting an intention, a direction, a place that you wanna go, and just knowing that it doesn't matter what I'm gonna face along the way, I'm going this way, right? Because in the end, the way I look at life, like, you can go a million different ways. You can go any way you want to, you know what I mean? You can go up that hill. You can go down that valley, you can sit in that city, you can come to my city, you can build something for yourself, you can work for the man, you can go a million different directions, right? Life is about all these infinite opportunities. No matter which way you go, no matter which way you go, there will be pain. Will be pain. It will be difficult. You will have to work hard. You will have to do it sometimes when you don't want to do it, right? If that's, you can do it for a job, somebody else. You can do it for yourself. You could do it for your teammates. You could do it for your kids, your nieces, all these people we just talked about. But it's no matter which way you're going to go, there's going to be pain. And there's going to be happy. There's going to be pleasure. You're going to get some type of rewards from it. You're going to get some type of achievement from it. You know, if you're at a job, you're going to get promotions. And they're going to reward you. And sometimes, you know what I mean? No matter what you do, it's going to be the same. They're just life is experiences. So you're going to experience, no matter where you go, you're going to experience some shit. Doesn't matter. You can't not experience some shit. So, pick a way. Dedicate yourself to that way. Say, look, man, I see everything there is to see out here. That looks the most fun to me. That life right there, doing that shit, riding those, that kind of whip, going on these vacations, whatever. Sitting on this type of house, whatever. You know, whatever. That's my shit. That's the shit I'm going for. Now, we got two options now. We either get there or we die. It's cool. Now it's just a time game. Now it's not an if game, it's a time game, right? Now it's just about how fast can I get there. But it's not about if I'm gonna get there. It's not about none of that. It's just about when. How fast can I, how smart can I be? How many shortcuts can I take? What can I learn that's gonna propel me there faster? But you see what I'm saying? That type of persistence, guys. Like, they call it the dummy proof, like, to the law of attraction, right? It's like, if you can't figure it out in a spiritual sense, if you can't figure it out on like an intelligent sense, like if you're just not a smart person and you just for some reason just cannot figure out how to connect to infinite source power and to just manifest with your thoughts, right? If you can do none of those things, there's a dummy foolproof plan. It's like the universe knows exactly what it's doing. It puts a way for every person to get it. And that way is persistence. I don't give a fuck how dumb you are. I don't care how low you start, how hard your climb is, none of that. If you put your head against something and you just put your head up against it as hard as you can forever and you just lean on it, I promise you, somebody's gonna help you. Somebody's gonna watch you after 20 years. They're just gonna feel bad for you and they're gonna help you. Or you know what I mean? Like, it does not matter, but the universe will not let you sit there and just lean on something with everything you have for 15, 30, 40 years. You hear these stories all the time. You ever hear about that man with the golden voice?
Hey, I'm gonna make you work for your dollar. Say something with that great radio voice.
When you're listening to nothing but the best of oldies, you're listening to Magic 98.9. Thank you so much. God bless you.
You remember, hey, this is the man with the golden voice. And they found him on the side of the fucking highway. And he had been through like this whole crazy, like been successful, lost everything, was like broke and got all cooked on drugs and all this stuff, 30, 40 years of like madness. And then one day he was just on the side of the road, spreading love and positivity on the side, probably dreaming about the old days. And then somebody was like, yo, let me make a video of you. And he went viral as fuck. And then now he became like the announcer for the Cleveland Cavaliers and shit. Like, he had like all these professional jobs, voiceover jobs, all this shit just came flying to this dude, right? Now that's like a 40, 50 year journey, right? But he's doing exactly what he wanted to do with his life, right? You know what I mean? I think he actually fucked it up again, because, you know, sometimes we just do that. If you don't fix the mindset, you'll just keep manifesting from that poor mindset. But nonetheless, my point was, eventually the universe will break. You know, like I said, you don't even have to come out here and take massive action. He took the slowest route possible to his dream and still made it. You know, so if you just have persistence alone, you'll win. That's why I don't worry about it. Like, that's why I don't come on here and like stress about how good my show is. You know what I mean? It doesn't matter right now. Well, as I go, I know I'm gonna learn. I'll get better, get faster, get sharper, speak better, learn how to, you know, whatever, get a fancier set, better cameras, all that comes, right? But right now, I just know, guess what? If I just do this every day, no matter how good I am, even if I fucking suck, if I just do this every day, bet you I win. Bet you I win. Have you ever Googled how to start a successful YouTube channel? Or anything like that? What do they tell you? You gotta do daily uploads. I've watched so many channels that are like, man, once I switched over to daily uploads, my shit just blew up. It's weird. Content didn't change, nothing, right? But the amount of action that they were putting out into the universe, right? The amount of will that they were putting out every single day planting a seed as compared to once a week planting a seed or some of those twice a month planting a seed. It just wasn't as strong, right? You learn so much faster by that many extra repetitions of doing your shit that many times. You get better. You get faster. Something about consistently, persistently chasing on something day in and day out, right? You get better at your job, Every year. And sometimes without even trying, you get better at your job. Why? Because you do it every day. You know? What you do, what you put your energy into, your focus is going to grow. Period. Doesn't matter what it is. You put your focus in negative shit, it's going to grow. Put your focus up in your job's going to grow. That's great. You get more job. You know, you focus it into how much you hate your job, guess what you're going to get? More shitty hating job. Right? Like, no matter what you put into, what your energy into, it's going to grow. But put it there, though. You know what I'm saying? Just keep it there. A lot of us, sometimes we get to planting our shit, and then, like, as soon as our shit gets to growing, and it's, like, about to bust up out, we're growing a tree. As soon as it's about to grow up, we're like, man, this shit's taking too long, man. I want that. You know what I mean? Or we just get bored. Or we just, like I said, we start to lose faith. We've been watering. And be like, after a while, you're like, man, I don't know, man. Maybe Rod is lying to us, man. Maybe it doesn't work. You know, that fear starts creeping. You're like, maybe, I don't know, maybe we should get a job. We kill it. That's right. It's so true. We're like, man, maybe I don't know, man. I don't know if I can make it this month. I have my bills and and then you quit or you do something dumb. You know, there's so many times they talk about these people who stop 2 feet, 10 feet from gold, right? They like tell this story, this old prospector. This is like, it's a famous story. I don't know if this is a real dude. I imagine that this guy is like, it's like a mythos, right? Of this old prospector guy. And this prospector, he goes out, takes all his equipment out. He says, I'm heading out west to find gold. And everybody's like, you're a crazy man. You know, it's crazy. It's dangerous out there. And you'll never find it. You know, it's a million chances to one. He's like, I'm going to find this shit. I'm going to go out there. And so he takes his whole family, everything out west, and he goes out there, and he starts off, he's so excited. You get your shit out here, because it's still the same. You get your shit out here to L.A., and you're like, woo, I'm in L.A., I'm going to make my dreams come true now. And you start digging, pow, 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 and you're like, oh, wow, it's a lot harder than I thought it was, man, digging this fucking shit. And you find out the rocks are a lot tougher than you thought they were, and they're not cracking as fast as you thought they were. Trust me, this is exactly how it goes. You're like, God, I gotta get a bigger shovel. You go run back, you get a bigger shovel, and you're like working, and then days go by, and weeks go by, and you're just shoveling. But after a while, it just gets so hard, because people come out and they keep, damn, Jim, still at it, huh? Yeah? We're all gonna go to the bar, man. You sure you don't wanna come out and get some drinks with us? And you're all still excited. Nah, man, gold to be had. Gotta get it. I'm gonna get it. And everybody else is like, all right, well, you know, best of luck, man. And then they all just talk shit about you behind your back. I really think Jim's losing it, man. He's been out there just digging that hole 24/7, day in, day out, right? This is how it goes, right?
One of my favorite all-time stories comes from the Bible of Personal Development, Think and Grow Rich. The very first chapter where they talk about 3 feet from gold. You remember the message. R.U. Darby was a young aspiring gold miner and got gold fever. Goes out west and starts digging. Sure enough, discovers a couple little nuggets in a hole. He buries it and hides it and goes home and tells his family and friends. Well, they chip in money to buy equipment to pull it out by the truckload. Well, sure enough, the first ore cart comes out and it's filled with gold. Woohoo! They're gonna be rich! And they kept digging, but the gold ran out. They kept digging, but there was no more gold. Defeated, Darby walks out of that mine and says, I quit, I'm through, and sees a junk man walking by. He says, hey buddy, give me $200. I'll sell you this mine and all the equipment. I'm going back home. Well, the junk man, realizing the equipment was worth thousands, said, of course, you got yourself a deal. And then Darby goes home defeated. But the junk man, he does something brilliant. He goes to a local engineer, an expert in mining, and says, what happened? Says, Darby hit gold and ran out. Well, the engineer starts laughing. He says, that's so simple. That's like mining 101. Everyone knows that gold runs in a straight line. It's called a gold vein. What Darby did is come in one side, hit gold, and he popped back into dirt. He said, all you gotta do is go back to where they discovered treasure, go 90 degrees, just 3 feet the opposite direction, and you'll tap back into the vein. Not only did the junk man pull millions of dollars out, but it still fills Fort Knox today.
Right? This is how it went back in 1800. This is how it goes now. You be on your grind, and then eventually you start to just wane, though. You start looking around, and you're like, man, well, those guys, they've been going to the bar and getting fucked up every day, and they got more money than me. Right? How come he got a promotion now and he gets to drive a Ferrari, and I'm still over here in my busted-ass Honda? And you start to forget what you were doing and why you were doing it. And so you lose faith. And then you kind of fall back in line with the rest of the sheep. you know, because it pulls to you. It's safer and easier. So you fall back into that. And usually right there, it's right there when that dude is like digging and everybody comes back around again. They're like, yo, man, just give it up, man. Like, geez, you've been out here for 4 years, 15 years, and still no gold. And he just like finally snaps. He's like, you're right. Can't do this anymore. And you walk away. And guess what? I come. I'm like, wow, I'm about to be digging for the rest of my life, and this is a big ass hole to get started in. Let me go ahead and just start right here. Bing, 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 and then it just fucking glitter galore for me, right? And it's like, damn, that sucks. You did all that work, but you gave up 10 feet from glory, you know? Right there at the finish line, you lose faith. So I don't want to be that guy. I don't know where it is. That's the funny thing about faith. And that's the funny thing about putting your belief into something. I don't know when it happens for you. Nobody knows. Nobody knows if it happens for you, right? We already talked about that. I don't got no magic genie lamp that says, oh yeah, if you think it hard enough, you're gonna be the best rapper in the world. There can only be one best rapper in the world. So I don't know if you're gonna make it. I don't know if that's your destiny. You can wish it all day long, but you also are designed to do something too. And I think that those things mix. But that's another conversation for another day. So you're wishing, I don't know if it's gonna happen for you, but this is what I do know. If you never give up, you'll never have to fucking find out. That's what I say. I'ma just keep going. And ain't nobody ever gonna laugh at me. I'ma die the crazy man. Die that motherfucker. They're gonna have to talk shit to me about me when I'm dead, long gone. They'll be like, yeah, man, I watched Rod try for 40 years and he never really made it. Yes, I did, bitch. You watched me for 40 years. Gotcha.
Gotcha, bitch.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I'ma win. I'ma do me. I'ma do this. Regardless, and not because I'm smart, not because I'm fast, not because I'm good looking, talented, lucky, none of that. I mean, all those things are gonna help faster, but in the end, you'll win on persistence alone. Dude, your brain is a supercomputer. Your brain is a supercomputer. The fastest, strongest machine the world has ever seen. We've never seen anything like it, I promise you, nothing. It can build skyscrapers, it can take people to the moon. All of those things came out of a human's mind. Everything you see around you right now came out of some human's mind. Just thought that shit up long enough, was like, man, wouldn't it be cool if we could fucking talk to each other from thousands of miles away? Fuck. Yeah, but there's nothing like that, man, so just shut the fuck up. And you're like, yeah, I know there's nothing like that, but what if there was? And then, if you just, what if there was? How could something like that be? What do I gotta do? What do I gotta find? Who do I have to pay? Who do I have to teach? What do I have to learn? What do we all have to come together to do, right? Bro, how do y'all think they solve the world's problems? Right now, if a meteor was gonna come down on Earth and it was about to crush and murder the entire planet, what would we do? How would we stop it? Ask yourself, what would we do as human beings? Meteor's coming, you got 2 years. 2 years, if you don't figure it out, all humanity's dead. What do you think we would do? We'd be at Mars tomorrow, motherfuckers. They would get all 20 minds from around the world would come and be like, hey, I'm smart. I came to think about this shit. You know, they would just show up. And just be, all of them would sit in a room and be like, all right, motherfuckers. Everybody grabs a goddamn pen. What you got? All right, what if we did this? What if we took a rock and we took a thing and we threw it into the thing and then a bunch of people go, no, fuck no, man, that would never work because this and this and this, and you're stupid, that doesn't work, and blah, 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 blah. And we do that for like a year, 2 years, 9 months, and then right before the meteor hits, I guarantee you, somebody's like, this! We just put everybody in ships and we blah, 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 and it is done. You know what I mean? It's done. But it all starts with the only Bruce Willis, right? Exactly. We'll find him. We'll make it happen. But it all starts with just the willingness for people to sit in a room and put their head on it until somebody figures it out. Period. That's it. Henry Ford talks about, oh, guys, if you stick with me and you're going to, soon we're going to break down Napoleon Hill's Think and Grow Rich, right? We're all going to go through it together. It's on an audio book. You can actually find it on YouTube if you want to go ahead and like jump the gun and get started ahead of time so you can be like with the shits. But it's going to be like a weekly thing. We're going to like, you know, this is the hour that we're going to listen to over the week, and then we'll come back on Tuesday and talk about what we learned. It's going to be super dope. I love that book so much. And one of the things he talks about is Henry Ford, right? Henry Ford and like how he built Ford Motor Company and all these different like things and the principles he put into play. But one of the things he talks about, persistence.
Now, I know what you're thinking. How the heck does a 52-year-old over-the-hill milkshake machine salesman build a fast food empire with 1,600 restaurants in 50 states, 5 foreign countries, with an annual revenue of in the neighborhood of $700 million? One word, persistence. Nothing in this world can take the place of good old persistence. Talent won't. Nothing's more common than unsuccessful men with talent. Genius won't. Unrecognized genius is practically a cliche. Education won't. Why, the world is full of educated fools. Persistence and determination alone are all powerful.
Simple persistence. He would say, like his engineers, right? He would pay these men and he would tell them, this is what I want you to do. I want you to create an 8-stroke engine that runs on this, this, and this and can, and you know, uses gasoline and runs on this. None of these things existed. Combustion engines and all this shit, none of these things existed, right? And so he would just hire the world's best engineers and these people. He put them in a room and say, this is what I want. You have everything you need. Goodbye. Right? And then he'd come back. Come back a couple weeks later. What you guys got for me? And then they would say, Mr. Ford, I'm sorry. We've been working our ass off and we've been trying, but we don't know. We can't solve it. We can't figure it out. It's impossible. You can't do anything like that. Blah, 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 blah. You know what Henry Ford would say? All right, keep trying. He would walk out. And then guess what? He'd come back a couple weeks later and he'd be like, how we doing? Well, we had a couple breakthroughs, Mr. Ford, but we still just, I don't know, and we've been spending a lot of money, and it's this and that, and, you know, because people are just naturally negative, and this is why we teach ourselves to be positive. This is why, I promise you. If you're ever like, what do I need positivity for? Well, because the road ahead is long and hard, and if you don't have positivity, you're going to quit. So that's it. The name of the game is don't quit, because if I don't quit, I win. That's it. So the name of the game is not how do I be the best or anything, it's just how do I not quit. How can I convince myself every day to just keep going, right? And so every time he would say, hey, I hear you. And then sometimes he doesn't tell them straight up. They'd be like, no, this is impossible. It can't be done. And he's like, are you sure? They're like, yes. And they'll never be done. Okay, cool, you're fired. You want to give it a shot? And then somebody else be like, yeah, I'll try, right? Why not? And then eventually what the fuck happens? One day he comes up in the fucking thing and they're like, Mr. Ford, yes, come, quick. Look at this. And they got a fucking car. And he's like, I knew you could do it. That's it. That's all Mr. Trevor Ford says. I knew you could do it. Great. Let's get it. Let's get it online. Let's go. Right? Because he just knows. He just knew that if a man just sits there and persistently fucking just drills his head on one idea, you're going to fucking figure it out. You're going to figure it out. This is the same for all of your problems. All your problems. Today's the first, and you don't know how you're going to pay rent tomorrow. Figure it out. You will. Bet you come up with the money in 3 days. I hope you don't rob nobody to do it, but you'll come up with an answer regardless. Right? So, it's about just having faith, being consistent, being persistent, right? Committing to an idea, having the discipline to just follow through on that idea that you committed to every single day, even when you don't feel like it. Right? Even when you don't feel like, oh, you know, keeping going or feel like getting out. Like, dude, think about some of the things that people do with their body or with their mind. You know, we got people out here who are climbing Mount Everest. You get up 3-4 days into Mount Everest, you don't get the chance to be like, oh, my body's tired, man. I don't think we're going to climb today, bro. I'm just going to take the day off, bro. This is so funny to me. People are like, I really went hard yesterday, so I got to take a break. Good. Go hard every motherfucking day. Like, I'm tired as fuck. And you heard me when I came on here. I was like, man, I don't know how I'm gonna make it. I'm already so fucking juiced off of just this tea and this conversation that I'm gonna still go out and do Lime Scooters. Why? Because I can. Honestly, because I can. Because, like, no matter how much I'm bitching in my mind, my body will actually go do it. You know what I mean? Like, if I actually just force myself to go out there and lift, it'll actually do all of that. It'll pick up the scooters and throw them. It'll do it. It's only about this conversation that I'm having in my mind, right? And so if you learn to quell that conversation, and it could be through anything. It could be through doing the gratitudes. And when your mind's like, nah, man, you really don't want that devil on your shoulder. You don't have to do that. Who's gonna know? Nobody knows if you do it or not. Just go to sleep. It's okay. It's okay. It's not okay, bitch. It's not fucking okay. Do the goddamn shit. And then do it every goddamn time. And then be proud of yourself that you did it. And then do it some more. But don't be like, yeah, I did it one time. Now I get to relax. Fuck that. Don't get that sense of entitlement. Don't ever like kick back off the pedal. Be persistent. Be consistent. Drive through on whatever the fuck it is you're trying to do. The harder you go, the faster you get there. Right? And there it is. Once you start deciding of whether or not you're in or out, that's where most people at. Most people aren't going hard because they're still trying to figure out if they're in or out. Playing double dutch with their dreams and shit. They're like, I'll try it for a couple weeks. All right, I did it. This is getting a little boring, a little difficult. I'll just go back to partying and fucking around with my friends. And we're like, and then this is completely unsatisfying, of course, right? So you do this for a little while and you're like, wait a minute. That's right, I wanted my dreams. And you come back out here and you start cooking with your dreams a couple more times, and you feel like, realize it's hard and difficult, and nobody listens to the shit you make, and nobody's out there fucking lining up around the corner to listen to your first vlog ever, and so you get discouraged. Oh, maybe I suck. Oh, well, fuck it then. I'm just gonna go be normal like everybody else. And then you realize that this is completely unsatisfying again, so you come back. Am I talking to anybody? Has anybody ever played this game before? Because I know I have. I've played this game. Once you just get in this though, and just every day you just gotta figure out, all right, how do I make this thing fucking pop? How do I make this thing better? You know, how do we grow into this? It's just a different mindset, different ball game you're playing. So I hope that helps, man. I hope that inspires somebody to do what I'm talking about right now. I'm gonna try my best to do it. I'm gonna do it. I told you guys, I love to share this with you, but it's not for you, it's for me. You know what I mean? Like, I'm gonna use it myself. I tell you what, it's difficult. And you know, sometimes you wanna just slump. And sometimes you will. Look, guys, like I told you, I started off this conversation. You've been here the whole time, you heard me. Take care of yourself. Take care of your body. It's your number one resource. So if you do drive it into the ground, you're right. You're not gonna get anything done, right? You waste this, you're gonna fuck yourself. So there is a such thing as overdoing it. But really flirt with that line a couple times, because the thing about it is you have to overdo it a couple times to really know what overdoing it feels like. You know what I mean? Like, if you've never actually collapsed from exhaustion, then it's really hard to know where that limit really is, right? And so push it all the time. Push it. Like, even now, like I said, I feel tired. I feel completely justified. I know that if I went to sleep right now, if I just turned off this live, laid down, I would feel like, I wouldn't feel bad about myself, right, or anything, because I deserve it. I work hard, I know that. But damn, how good am I gonna feel if I do it, get all the rewards from that, and then I go to sleep, right? And then I like, you know? So, whatever, man. Let your passion drive you, let your passion fuel you, but pick it, stay consistent every single day, figure it out. Every single day, push the limits of it. Give it more, feed it more, you know? I love the last analogy. I'm gonna leave you with this. I promise I'll leave it. You know, like Les Brown talks about this. How long would you give your child to walk before you just said, ah, shit, my child is just not a walker? You know? You would teach your kid every day. I don't care if your kid's like 15, 20 years old, and if they don't know how to walk, you're still in the doctor's office trying to figure out how to get them like artificial legs or something, you know? You would try, and your kid would learn how to walk, period. You know, most do. You know, it's like there's very few kids out here who just never learned how to walk. There's a lot of kids who can't walk, but there's very few kids who just never learned how, right? It's because, like, persistence. You're gonna do it. So, same thing, man, is if it's not working right now, just keep working it. Just keep molding it. Just keep figuring it out. Just keep pushing on it. Just keep bringing more stuff into it. But whatever you do, whatever you fucking do, don't you fucking give up. Don't you fucking give up. If you don't give up, I won't fucking give up. I mean, better yet, I won't give up, and that way you can't give up, right? Let's go, Grind Gang. I love you so much.